Hello guys, and welcome to another video here with Mr. Folkers. Again in my Object 140. I had this battle also, well, yesterday now. You may have seen my recent video on Alaluf with Object 140, and this battle was on the same day. So, here on Malinovka, as you can see, the enemy team just two mediums, E-50 and Lorraine, and a lot of heavies and tank destroyers. One off each side, T-50 is announcing he would spot the middle, more like suiciding in the middle, I guess. I loaded premium shells, see if I could get some damage in at least, considering so many heavily armored tanks on enemy side. But still, two misses there, one most likely just hitting the gun on the Jag Tiger. Amazingly, I'm actually able to penetrate I-7 there. Looks like I just hit straight into the turret, so even with premium I wasn't expecting that to penetrate. But no problem, just reload back into normal shells there and get going. As you know, Malinovka is often very much about that hill, so I'm going to pause a bit there. As you can see, we've got two batchat already up on the hill, well, nearly up on the hill now. E-50 last spotted over there, and I'm thinking that the enemy team will most likely not push up the hill at all. But I'm considering now to get myself into a bit of a position over here on this hillside, so I'm just going into the water and go and try to get myself over. It's a really strong position if you can get yourself into here. You can spot enemy tanks trying to get up here and spot into our side here, and also if there are enemy tanks pushing up the hill, you can get shots into them. So you see that these days, often at least with light tanks moving up there, spotting. So it's a really strong position to be in if you can get up there. But as you see, I can't really keep my speed up here in the water, just over 20 km per hour here, closing in on 30 but around 25, so rather dangerous move, I guess. I haven't done this too often, so I'm a bit inexperienced doing this, but always fun to try something new. Thankfully I wasn't spotted going over there, so no shots coming my way. So as you see now, I have the Lorraine up on the hill here. And also, as you know, he's a rather soft target. Not much armor to this tank, so just able to penetrate his turret there with no problem. And get another one into him. And also with 5.44 second reload, no problem reloading in time to take my third shot and kill the Lorraine there. As you can see now, T-57 is rather skilled, so he sees the danger of me being here. So he's just pulling back and getting himself out of this location, because if he had stayed put here, as I spotted him first time, he would be exposed all the time, because I would so easily just spot him there. So I'm much more safer here on my side from artillery, because you got this rather steep hill here. So really difficult for artillery guys on enemy side to get a shot into me here. And also on this side, I really can't get myself too much up here, considering if I sit up here and get spotted, I will most likely, well, you are on a bit for high ground, I guess. So also, I don't have that much experience being in this position, so I'm better safe than sorry. But I'm thinking that if I'm up here too far, I will have several shots coming my way from various tank destroyers and heavy tanks on enemy side, shooting up on me. So I'm just trying to spot here, And as you see, the E5 pops up there. So get a flanking shot into him. My team have the hill now, several tanks up there. But as you know, with a lineup like this, so many big guns camping around there, it's really dangerous to go just all in attacking. You have so many guns just sitting there and aiming for you. So very dangerous here to move in on the enemy. And also really boring of the enemy to just camp like this because it's just going to be such a waiting game here. Have to be patient and pick my moments. Just trying to spot there, and I really don't, I'm not in a position to get shots down on these guys because I can't expose myself too much. I take a blind shot there in the direction of the ISA, but I don't think I hit anything. So again up here, looking for that E5. You can't get shot on a T-57 because he's behind that hill. E5 got spotted again, but he's on the other side of the building. So 50B got him spotted, but I was afraid I was spotted myself there, so just pulling back, but I wasn't spotted. So hope to get a shot into him, but I guess he had sixth sense there, so he knew he was spotted, so he was pulling back into safety again. So I tried to be a bit more brave here, moving forward, trying to spot something, but so many bushes and trees here. And also now you see the my team is attacking down from the hill, so I'm able to just put flanking shots into the E5 here. And also I'm rather safe here doing this now, considering I'm a bit down in the a slope here. So as you can see now, the bat chat is going all in up there. And while these guys are concentrating on the my teammates up on the hill there, I at least got one into the 50B, but I got spotted, so pulling back again. Batchat got killed. And the other Batchat is just racing away here. And also, quickly, as you saw there, the E5. Two shots and he was dead. That's how dangerous it is going forward with so many enemy tanks just waiting for you, sitting still and sniping. Sorry for my poor English. So E100 again there. This time I take a shot on him, unable to penetrate. First time I spotted him, I didn't take a shot because I thought he had such an angle on his armor that he wouldn't penetrate anyway. And also, really don't want to shoot too much here because you are so easily spotted when shooting because you lose your camo value doing that. So, got the E3 here, and just pointing out, rather fun, but this E3. He contacted me in chat after the battle, screaming and shouting and claiming that I had a reload hack and I would be reported by him. So well, I hope I'm not going to get banned here anytime soon. As you know, it's no such thing as a reload hack in World of Tanks. You be the judge. As you can see, I don't really have any reload hack. He just got hit by several tanks on my side. Guess maybe artillery on my side also hit him. Also, if you see chat here, lol object report hack. It's your typical raging person on the live server. I guess they don't really understand the game mechanics and thinks there are cheaters around in World of Tanks, but as you may know, everything is calculated server side, so you really have to hack the servers of Wargaming to be able to pull off any cheats in this game. I offered him in chat after the battle to watch my replay. I may contact him again and let him know that he's on YouTube. But he wouldn't listen to me at least. He just scream and shout that I was hacking, and that was all he said. So, good spot on Jagpanzer. I was afraid to be spotted up there, so just quickly get myself back into cover. Better safe than sorry. So again, very much a waiting game here. 5-9 the score, so not looking good for my team here. Trying to spot the Jagpanzer again. I don't have a shot on him, so also I got spotted now. Take a blind shot towards the E5 there. And also I didn't notice that the E5 got killed by the team 7 heavy, so I try another blind shot. But at least now I saw that the E5 over there got killed by the team 57 heavy. So moving forward again, I'm thinking about trying to spot that Jagpanzer down there again. But as you see now, he actually got killed by artillery, so he took a blind shot there. So very nice shot from the artillery on my side. T-57 over there. Hoping to get a shot in here. And I missed, but anyway, Jag Tiger took out the T-57, but he paid for that. T-30 killed the Jag Tiger. And the T-30 is moving back into cover into the forest there. So again, just a waiting game. So as you can see in chat there, Batchat pointing out to me, come and help him with the T-30 pinging the map there. But I really don't want to take the risk of moving over there and trying to get the T-30 while you have the 50B down here. And also several tanks over on the other side sniping up then. So really dangerous to do that, I feel at least. As you can see also on minimap, the IS-8 is all alone over at our base there. Now the E-100 has moved over also, and the IS-7 is there. So I take some shots here in the direction where I see them on the minimap. Because of the max view range, I can't really see them, but looking at the minimap, I at least know they are there. And here you got a 50B coming for me. As you see, thankfully he's rather low health here. So I get one into his weak turret, pull back, reload, and get another shot into him and kill him. So thank you for doing that, so I can get him out of the way. And also artillery gets one into me now. I guess he's over on this side, considering he hit me there. So quickly just repair and get myself out of there. I'm thinking about going back to base and help out, but then I'm turning back, considering the T-30 is all alone up there now, and only the FV-250B on this side. So I'm thinking that now I don't have the 50B down there spotting me, so maybe I can get a spot on the enemy tanks left here now. But I'm a bit unsure. Real dangerous considering the 215B, the FV. So I stopped there, considering maybe he's sitting there sniping in. So if I go too far here, I'm going to be spotted. and take a big hit from him, the FV215B. But then, as you see, the T30 pops out here, and funnily enough, the is not visible yet when I paused. You can see the outline. So yeah. So as you see now, he comes for me there, and he actually bounced me. So I really can't pull back now. I just have to go for this while I can. Try one on the move, but just try and circle this guy. Hope that he's not shooting me back there. I know the T30 has a rather long reload here, and of course I had to make it interesting and bounce him. But I get him off the way, and also as you see here, the FV is actually not paying attention to me up here. I guess it was a rather boring battle, so he's gone to sleep over there. But as you saw, he started turning at least, so I load premium here. Make sure, well, not to make sure, but at least have a better chance of penetrating this guy. Get myself into cover. Thankfully I have a really low profiled medium tank here, so he was not able to take a shot on me. And also artillery on my team is doing a really good job here, taking out our FV, and the Batchat is racing over. And as you see, he takes out the IS-7, so all of the sudden, only artillery left here on the enemy side. So thankfully able to win this, and also get this rather boring battle out of the way. So load back the normal shells here and give this guy one back, considering he hit me earlier. So took one bounce there on the turret. So you can bounce with this turret, but also easily penetrated considering the weak spots on top there. But it's such a small medium tank, low profiled, so it's very nice to, and can stay hidden and use the terrain to advantage. Sorry for my poor English. Yeah, so that's all for this battle. Hope it was not too much boring to watch. I guess it wasn't the most exciting battle to view. Anyway, that's all I have for this time. So let's just move on and have a look at that battle result. And just quickly going through the battle result here. Rather nice credits. 108,000 and very close to 2,000 experience. 1921. Confederate I got, and also as you can see, rather poor hit percent there. Many misses, I guess. So 6002 damage and 24 potential damage received, and 3585 damage upon spotting. 11 damage, 1 spotted and 4 destroyed. Used some pram shells I guess there, so nearly 40,000 profit. So overall a good game on Malinovka, I guess. And that was the end of this video. So hope you have fun that battlefield, and also hope to catch you next time. Yeah, have fun on that battlefield, and bye for now then, guys.